Hi everyone, and welcome to the 2020 graduate animation screening. Sorry we couldn't be there with you guys in person this year, but we decided with the students to have an online screening as a starting point this year. Hopefully next year we can do a physical screening either at the Art College or perhaps a cinema or similar. But for now, I'd like you to watch and enjoy the hard work by our students over the last 9 to 12 months. There's really, really great variety of work this year, and we changed the format very slightly. So it's not just short films that are being presented tonight, there's also more portfolio-based projects in different disciplines as well. So I hope you enjoy the work as much as we've enjoyed guiding the students to create the work over the last year. After this little intro, we have examples of work from our first year class, our second year class, our master's program, and our graduate year, of course. And we have three awards tonight as well. We have the 16 South Student Excellence Award. We have the FlickerPicks Best Animated Short Award, and we have the Humane Students' Choice Award as well. And after those awards, the short films and projects will begin. Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy the show. Feel free to use the live chat as well to comment and say congratulations to the students as well at any point this evening. And the stream tonight will also be made available online for 1 week after tonight as well, if you want to go back and rewatch anything.
Congratulations. We are very proud of you, all the students.
Hey guys, congratulations on finishing. It was a great, amazing journey to be part of your really good, really cool projects. It was great to be part of or working among such talented year group. I wish you the best for all your future endeavors and good luck.
Congratulations everybody, really proud of the work that you've achieved this year, and like Henry, I just look forward to see what you're doing in the future as well.
Hey guys, it's been great to kind of be with you throughout the final year. You guys have done some amazing work with some fantastic projects, and really excited to see how you guys kind of develop and where you go, but you should be super proud of what you've been able to achieve this year, and great work all around. And yeah, we're looking forward to seeing all the films together tonight. So well done, guys.
Hey guys, congratulations. Truly exceptional work, really. It was always a delight just to come in, not just to talk to you guys, but to see what you were working on, kind of how your projects were getting on. And I think it's safe to say that everyone feels that you're all going to have like a very fantastic future in the industry. And it'll be very exciting and interesting to see what you guys go on to do. And I look very much forward to seeing where you all end up.
Great. And Daryl, our other technician, couldn't be here this morning, but he'd also like to congratulate everyone on their hard work and wish everyone well for the future. And I'd just like to say as well, thank you to the staff team as well for the hard work over the year and everyone's dedication even during the lockdown period, which was tough for everyone to adjust to. But congratulations for everyone to come through that. And enjoy the films.
Let's all try it together, shall we? One, two, three.
Hey Leanne, congratulations. You are the winner of the Excellence in Animation Award that we sponsor here at 16 South. I'm sorry I can't be with you to congratulate you in person this year, but I hope you're really proud of your achievement. Your work looks fantastic. So congratulations, well done.
Hi everyone, it's Johnny from FlickrPix here. Before I announce the winner, I would just like to say congratulations to every student for your achievements this year. The standard of these films, they'd be high under normal circumstances, but considering what we've been through, each of you should be incredibly proud of yourselves. I don't want to go through individual films, otherwise I'll be here all day. Such was the high standard that you all set. But there can only be one winner. So the winner of the best animated short film of 2020 is Space Chase. Congratulations, guys. Well done.
Hi, Animation. Thanks a million for allowing our team to participate in this year's celebration again. We know that everyone has been working incredibly hard, and it must have been especially difficult this year while completing your degree in a lockdown. However, it does not appear to have impacted on the amazing work that you've completed. Showing that you're all not only great animators, but are resilient and resourceful as well. Skills that will do you well over the coming years. So it gives us great pleasure to announce the winner of the Humane Student Choice Award. The student chosen by all the other students as the student who supported them the most throughout their degree. And the winner is... That's right. Yaz Heron. Yay. Woo. Congratulations, Yaz.
Hello, we are the team that created real-time sci-fi short Space Chase. In Space Chase, a space repairman crash lands on an alien planet, and along with his little robotic buddies, he has to source a fuel and get on out of there. It's basically an action yarn which turns into a comedy chase and a lot of laughs ensue. I'm Alistair Lyons. I'm a 3D generalist and character animator for the project. I focused on acting, action, and performance, and a little bit of cinematography.
Hi, my name is Mike Lilly. I worked as a generalist and technical artist in the project, primarily on rigging, environment art, modeling, and a bit of texturing. I worked mainly on the alien character and rigging the astronaut, but also mainly on texturing and building the alien temple environments.
Hello, I'm David Pollock. I also worked as a 3D generalist and a technical artist. I was involved in modeling, texturing some hero assets. I also modeled the Repairbot character on the rocket ship. I also made some environments in Unreal Engine. And I hope you enjoy the short. Thank you.
Thank you. Hi everyone, my name is Ruxandra Popescu and I'm a 3D animator.
My project is called The Lost Forest and it is loosely based on Romanian folklore. Part of it was made in Maya and rendered in Arnold, and part of it was made in Quill in virtual reality. The assets and characters in Quill were animated frame by frame, while everything in Maya was animated pose to pose. You will notice two very different aesthetics and animation styles, and I hope you enjoy them.
In times long past, far away in an eastern land now long forgotten, there was a forest so tall that it pierced the sky. The trees were filled with magic, and there lived some of the most ancient creatures the world had ever known. Between the thick leaves and twisting branches, the mother of the forest was rushing towards a village.
"What are you doing, foolish boy?"
argued the bewildered woman while struggling to break free.
"I knew you'd show up eventually, Mother of the Forest. I want you to put the grown-ups to sleep. I'm not little anymore. I have friends, and I want to play and make them sleep forever."
"You cannot understand this, youngling. But I cannot give you tonight's harvest."
With that, the child scoffed and opened his mouth to voice in protest. The woman continued talking in a grave tone.
"I have always lived here. Long before your people were even born. Everything in this forest belonged to me and my children. We all lived together in harmony with the forest. The cycle of life went on undisturbed for centuries, and no one ever bothered us until one day." It had been a warm day, and all the children were resting in the great glade. The hum of a few lazy bees accompanied the playful trickling of a nearby stream. In the soft, drowsy light of an early afternoon, the buzzing of life was quieting down. And then it stopped completely. With a sudden swoosh, the sun disappeared behind a mass of bubbling darkness. As the black cloud grew closer to the meadow, it began spouting ash and sharp spikes in every direction. That is when their mother awoke from her afternoon nap. Upon seeing the terror surrounding her, she rushed to help her children, now engulfed in the black smog, only to find out there was nothing she could do. In a desperate attempt to alleviate their pain, she made them all sleep. That is when I realized nothing would hurt them long as they are wrapped in dreams, said the mother tearfully, her head stooped into her chest. Have you never wondered why your tribe never goes below the treetops? With a soft whisper, the kid replies, I have. The boy considered his request. He knew the story to be true. Nobody in his village was allowed to venture beyond the great glade, and the few who dared were never seen or heard of again. I like your spirit, child, but you must sleep and dream now, she said, as she conjured some sleep dust and waved it in front of the boy. As an old saying goes, necessity knows no law. She escaped her captor, but she knew there would be no real freedom for her. Not now, nor ever. As for the boy, it will all have been a dream.
My name is Owen Monaghan. I'm a 3D generalist. I just recently graduated from Ulster University. And the theme of my animation is actually quite a serious one. It's about child soldiers, which is quite a sensitive issue, but it's not unusual that students from all around the world every year will do projects based on sensitive issues. And I'll actually be raising money for this particular issue on Facebook, which will be across my social medias. I'll be talking about that. And there is some violence in the film, so I'll warn you now in case you're sensitive to violence. I'd also like to give a shout out to the tutors who were amazing during this whole quarantine lockdown and provided us with all the help that we needed. I'd like to give a shout out to Michael Janica, who did the music for the film, and as well my classmates, who are some of the most talented artists that I've had the pleasure of working alongside. And I hope you can appreciate the animation for what it is, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the films. Thank you. And I'll be sure to put up contact details at the end of this video. Thanks.
I'm Darcy. I'm an illustrator, graphic designer and animator from Northern Ireland. My animation is called Sardines on Toast, and in it, a young woman, Fern, who's just moved into her first house on her own, is realising the lonely monotony that can happen when you don't have a friend or a partner to keep you company. But as the night goes on and she starts to prepare her dinner, she might just stumble across something that solves her lonely predicament. My animation was first inspired by a painting that I did on my placement year, but as time went on and COVID began, it actually began to suit the current situation pretty well. This is my first attempt at 2D animation, and I'm so proud and excited to be able to call it my own. I created the whole thing in Photoshop, using layers to create the lines, colours and textures, and then brought it into After Effects to do all the editing and post-production. A massive thank you goes out to the whole team at Ulster University for supporting me throughout this whole thing, and also to my team at the BBC who I worked with for my placement year. They provided me with so many helpful tips and tricks to help me with the editing process, and I couldn't have done it without them. So thank you everybody, and I hope you love it. Bye.
Hi guys, I'm Dermot Burns, and I'm a 3D generalist and environment artist. My short film is called Forest. It's an experimental film with a focus on the environmental issues. I want to thank Amy Kirkham-Priester for the beautiful animation she done in this short film. I also want to thank the lecturers and Ulster University for all the support they gave us throughout the lockdown. And one more, I want to thank my friends and family for the support they gave me throughout the year. Thanks for listening, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the short films.
Hello, my name is Jack Ellison and I'm a 3D generalist. My major project this year was a solo character design portfolio piece. It was focused around creating two fantasy AAA game characters called Neela and Estril, and then taking them through the entire game character production pipeline from creating their concept to creating game animations with them. Neela is an elven archer from a tribe who were created by Mother Nature herself to protect the forest, and Estril is her one-of-a-kind elemental forest wyvern companion. The idea of these characters stemmed from a sketch I created over the summer before this project, and then I developed it and it grew from there. It was a lot of fun working on this project, and I hope you like it.
Hi, my name is Claire McKinney, and this year I created a 2D children's animation called Huff Puff. Huff Puff is based on a poem that I wrote a few years ago that describes a conversation between a little boy and his older sister. The story is about finding harmony in nature and accepting chaos. It's just about learning to accept things and let things be. This is my first time working on a 2D animation, and I really loved learning the workflow and experimenting with the style. I want to say a quick thank you to everybody that helped contribute to this project. So thank you to Jacob Mattis, he's an amazing 2D animator who'll be going into final year next year and was a massive help in this project. Thank you to my sister Megan McKinney for creating the audio for this project. And of course thank you to all my voice actors who helped bring the characters to life. So thanks to my dad Niall McKinney for narrating, my cousins Matthew and Annie for voicing the little boy and the duck, and to my friend Emily Deal for voicing the little girl. And of course, thank you to all our tutors and for all their help and advice throughout the years. I'm really going to miss everybody, and I've loved my time at Animation in Ulster. And I hope that you enjoy the video. Thanks very much. Bye.
The little boy cried.
The girl replied,
"For creatures big and creatures small, go their own way, that's all."
Ignoring her words of advice and dissuasion, he lifted a creature, confused, and replaced him. In a row he set it, in a row with its friends. In a row was how he likes them.
Neat and tidy,
he defends.
Just wait.
The girl smiled.
Just wait,
she said. And just as she warned him, out of line they transcend. Determined to succeed in his plans for direction, he marched over to the pond to teach those ducks a lesson. But as he tried to sort them, they fluttered, squawked, and flew. They flew away into the sky.
Far, far away from you.
The boy disapproved of their disorganized fashion.
I just want my ducks in a row. Won't they have some compassion?
So he slumped to the ground, deflated, disgruntled, and frustrated, when the girl sat opposite and kindly stated,
"All well and good that you like things ordered, but not everyone is like that. Not everyone can be bothered. Nature is free and messy and lovely. It has its own soul, its own pattern to follow. Believe it or don't, that's your choice to make. But don't try and control it, for goodness sake."
The ocean tells me of its woes, of winds and waves and violent throes, of all the tides it has to bear, the weight of life it holds in care. And I that dripped upon the land, evaporating on the sand, must swallow all when I but see breadth, depth, immortality.
Peggy 16.
Hi, my name is Lauren Bell. I would say that I'm both a 2D and 3D artist. Probably most of my experience would be within 3D from both my work experience alongside my university work. Within these areas, I'd say my strengths would probably be asset modeling and character modeling and texturing. As well as this, I really enjoyed 2D work and I really enjoyed drawing with my concept work for, say, the environments and character designs, but also just general like illustrations of films that I really, really like. For this particular project, I found that my main influences were The American Office and What We Do in the Shadows. And I really like the kind of comedy style of those types of films and TV shows and their sort of mockumentary style that I wanted to emulate. I also like Pixar films like Wall-E and Up and the kind of wholesome, fun-loving nature that they have. This project was fantastic because it was quite large and it meant that I could get some help for my asset modeling and the rigs, and the people that helped me would have looked at my concept sketches for the different environments, and they worked really, really well, and I think it really, really helped me actually get the project done, and I'm really appreciative for that. But yeah, the project was really big and I'm just really happy to have it all done. And I worked really hard on it, so I really hope you enjoy it. Thank you very much for listening.
This is 22-century-old Gwaline Wilfred.
You see over here.
He's welcomed 0.22-century-old human, Alex, at his home on Quarville for the past month.
Species knows much more than yours.
Right now, he's taking Alex on the very human activity, bird watching, to make him feel more at home.
I'm going to take Alex over here to look for rabbits.
There are no birds on Wilfred's planet. So, Wilfred, tell us a bit about the accommodation you set up for Alex.
Well, I've made sure to supply his room with the finest human items for his demographic. Look, over here. Check out these authentic human goggles. And this big box of glowing cuboids. Humans love these. I've also made sure to provide Alex with nutritious sustenance.
So, in such a small space, how do you ensure Alex's privacy needs are being met?
I just make sure to keep my distance. Having your own room is also great for human privacy.
Lovely. So, what do you do for fun with Alex?
Well, there are plenty of human activities I host to make Alex feel like he's on Earth. Music has been a huge part of human culture for centuries. Today, I'm going to play a classical piece in tribute to Alex's planet. BDes is where our chicks would be, if we had any. And this is where our pigs would be, if we had any. So, overall, I'm pretty happy with the experience. I already knew so much about humans and human culture. Now Alex has taught me so much more. What do you think, Alex?
Hi, I'm Mark McCauley. I'm a 2D animator. I'm now a graduate of University of Ulster. My final year animation, Shortcut, is my first full solo project while at university, and is a horror short, which is something I've wanted to do for all 3 years of my degree. A little bit of a content warning, there are some scenes of gore and scenes of peril in this short, so I get that a lot of the other things presented here are a bit more light and comedy focused, or at the very least more family friendly viewing, so that's just something to maybe keep in mind with it. I just want to give a big shout out to everyone who helped me making this project. While it was mainly solo, I definitely had a lot of help from a lot of people. And so, yeah, I hope you enjoy this pretty short horror animation.
Right. Can you see the forest down there? Cut through there, and we'll have our camp ready for sundown.
Sounds good, dude.
Okay. Just over the wall here. Through these woods. Not much longer now. Alright. Be ready to go. What's up?
Very welcoming.
Aye. Alan, you sure this is the way?
I am. I mean, we knew there could be dangerous animals up here. Look, if we just stick together, get our fire going, we'll be grand.
Okay, man. It's not like we have anywhere else to go.
Oh, this is the place then.
Aye, and right on time. Let's get set up. Think it's time to hit the hay. We've got an early start tomorrow.
Yeah, up early to get out of here. Right, away to the loo. Give us a moment.
Don't go too far. It's easy to get lost out there.
Yeah? Why not come with me then? Stick together and all. Sure, wanna give me a hand with it?
No need for the attitude, dude.
Look, it's late. Just stop bickering. Good night, boys.
Huh?
Here?
Man, what time even is it?
Hey, what's up? Oi! Where are you guys?
Come with me.
If you're trying to prank me... Huh? What the fuck is... that? Alright, this isn't funny, guys. Where even am I?
Lost out there.
Why not
early start?
Together? Stick?
Attitude? No need. Right on time.
Alan! Ian! Where are you?
Give us a moment.
Ian. Oh my god. There you are. What's going on?
Wanna give me a hand with it? Why not come with me then? Stick together and all. Yeah. Give us a moment. Get out of here.
Stop. What the fuck? Oh fuck. Is that you, Alan?
Good night, boys.
Hi, my name is Rachel. I'm a 3D generalist. I've been working on the short film Manny for the past year. I specialise in 3D modelling, lighting and texturing, and these are the characters from that short film, so I really hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Good morning. It's a sunny start to this Valentine's Day. To keep in with the warm weather, we want to hear your stories that will warm our hearts. My 8-year-old nephew, I hope you won't mind me saying, came to me and told me that he was going to give away his favorite toy car to a girl in his class because he wanted her to have a part of him. He said that if it made her as happy as it made him, then he wanted her to have it. It was the sweetest thing. So, if you have any heartwarming stories to share, please get in touch by calling
5 years. Hi, my name is Shaw Bryans and I'm 22 years old. For my final year project, I decided to focus on my favourite part of the 3D animation pipeline, which is the actual animation of characters themselves. My final year project, a study of game animation, particularly focuses on combat animation for video games. Each animation I've created can be looped and placed into a video game engine right now. The rigs I use, the Zelda rig is created by Christoph Scooch and the Ezra rig is created by Game Anim. So without further ado, thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy.
My name is Maggie McDermott. I am a final year student at Ulster University. I specialize in character modeling and asset modeling, and I also do a lot of 2D work as well. My final year film focused mainly on those aspects of character and asset modeling. It's a story that my dad wrote for my mother. It follows a young girl and a father going out on a walk one day, and she feels very upset and insecure because she can't really keep up because she's very small. But my influences for this film were mainly a lot of children's media. So specifically, I looked at things like Brother Bear for color scheme and everything, while also looking at 3D elements like Moomin Valley, which focused a lot of layering 2D backgrounds with 3D media, which is what I do in my film. It was a lot of work, and I'm very proud of what I have to offer, and I'm also very happy it's over. So with that said, I hope you enjoy the film.
What troubles you, little hands?
The grass is too tall, the trees are too high, and the ground is too hard. But it's all just right for you. I can't keep up. I'm scared I will never grow big and strong. I will never be able to catch up.
Do you know why I named you so? Your mother and I were many summers old when we married. We wanted very much to have children of our own. The gods saw fit to bless us with you. When I first held you in my arms, you opened your eyes and grabbed my nose with your little hands. I knew then that these little hands were special. I knew that my hands could reach the sky, but your little hands could reach my soul. I named you Little Hands, not for how big you are, but because I want to forever remember that you are my little girl. And that one day, when you grow tall and strong, you may not need me anymore. Your name reminds me that when you put your little hands in mine, I am still your father, your friend, your teacher, and your protector. That little hands is why you bear the name that I gave you.
Is Claire McMurray. I have currently been studying a degree within animation
within the Ulster University, which I have now completed. I have chose to specialise in the field of concept art and grow my drawing ability and my skill set. My project is called The Order, and it is set in the future in the year 2030. It explores the possibilities of a cybernetic utopian city and the benefits and downsides of this. I also wanted to explore themes such as what truly makes us human and when do we cross this line. I feel like my project has answered this question somewhat, and it will continue to grow the more I work on it, and I do intend to continue to work on it even though my degree is currently finished. Thank you for listening to this short bio about me. Sit back and relax and enjoy my project.
Welcome to the Order. You will now be programmed. In the rules and regulations of the Order, you will commit your mind to us. You will obey the Order's rules. You want to obey the Order. You are committed to R.I.D.S. You will serve Magnus. Without question. You will now be programmed. You will commit your mind to us.
Hi, my name's Bradley. I've just finished final year studies of animation. Just want to say a quick congrats to everyone in final year. It's been very inspiring. They get to work alongside you. So yeah, all the best in the future. I'd like to be doing more with the music. Making animations tailored towards music videos would be ideal. So my final year project is called Connect.exe, and it's a horror thriller style animation. It's about a woman being trapped by a mechanical entity that we don't really know much about. Just a wee quick disclaimer though, if you are photosensitive or prone to seizures, I recommend maybe skipping this one. There's a lot of flashing lights, but except for that, enjoy.
Thank you to everyone who has helped make this short possible, and to our family and friends for their continued support.
We really hope you enjoy our short.
Okay, so what's your name and your area of interest?
So my name is Leanne Hillen, and my area of interest is visual development and concept art.
So what is the nature of your project?
So for my project, I decided to create a visual development art book that shows my exploration sketches for creating my imaginary world of Zolgaba, which is based off themes around Irish mythology.
So I heard about this island, and it is known as the Phantom Island, that appears off the west coast of Ireland every 7 years, and it was depicted in all the ancient medieval maps, and it was called High Brazil. So sailors tried to sail their boats to High Brazil, but failed many times, and but people from the west coast of Ireland said that they could see a mass floating in the sea with smoke bellowing out of it and spirits, and rumours went around that it was an island of the dead. But also there's accounts from the 1500s and the 1300s of people who said they've reached the island. And upon getting there, they've been greeted by an old man who told them to get off because it was enchanted and that they couldn't be there. And one man actually received a book from the island and didn't open it for 7 years. But once he opened it, he realised he was able to heal people, so he just got the gift of healing. And so this story really made me think about the untold stories of Irish mythology and Ireland's past that no one knows about. And so this was another driving factor that made me create Zulkiba. So every land has to have a map. And so I covered the map and loads of different areas that I unfortunately couldn't explore all. So I just focused a tiny bit on a few select ones and drew out some props and world building sketches. So for the book, I thought to research into some characters that I could start developing and maybe focus the book around one tale in particular. And the one that stood out was the tale of Lug and Balor, who are well-known Irish mythological characters. So in regards to Lug and Balor, the story started with Balor. He's an evil king and he ruled the land. And he was told a prophecy from a druid or a soothsayer who warned him that his future grandson would murder him. And as it goes with most evil characters, he locks his only daughter in a tower to prevent her from meeting any men and conceiving any children. But she does meet a man and she does conceive, and Ethne ends up having three triplets who are drowned, but one survives, and this is Lug. So little baby Lug is floating down the river and ends up in the swamps of a colossal sea creature called Sailu, who stumbles upon Lug and takes him in as his own, and ends up bringing him up and training him to prepare him for avenging his brother's death and eventually killing Balor with a slingshot. So in terms of visual development, as I progressed, I just designed more characters that revolved around Lug and Balor, and some creatures. So Lug's hound, Cain's magical cow who never ran dry from milk, Sailu, who was Lug's foster parent, and Resax, who is Balor's trusty raven who scours the land for any predators or potential threats. So overall, I really, really enjoyed this project. It was really fun being able to take some time and design some characters that are from my own imaginary world, a new land. And I intend to keep on developing this world after graduation and creating some nice paintings and a continuous flow in my portfolio as time goes on. I felt like I've only just touched the tip of the iceberg in regard to the project. And that there's many, many more tales to be told.
Hey guys, my name is Ryan Loughran and I hope you're enjoying the show so far. It sucks that we can't all be together this year to watch the show, but it's brilliant that the lecturers were able to put on this live stream for us. For the past year, I've been working on a character-based portfolio piece in real time, inspired by Japanese history and folklore. I really wanted to just test my limits as a character artist and to further my knowledge in a real-time pipeline. After university, I plan to continue developing my skills as a character artist and eventually break into the games industry and pursue a career as a game artist. I've been very lucky to share this year with a very talented group of people, and I'm excited to see what everyone goes on to do after graduation. So without any further ado, I hope you enjoy the rest of the show, and I hope you enjoy my project. Thanks very much.
I did the modeling for the car and the rigging for the car, and also helped out on animating and lighting.
I'm Yaz. My main roles were to be the lead animator and the producer for the film, but also dabbled in some other stuff in generalism as well.
Hi, I'm Lydia. I did the lighting and rendering on the film, as well as editing and compositing.
Hi, my name's Nida. I was the lead character artist on the film Come Home, as well as helped out with some general stuff to do, like animating and stuff.
We came together at the end of our placement years and had a meeting about becoming a team, and we realised we were all really into like story-driven animation, and we all had very different skill sets that seemed to come together to make the perfect sort of production team. And we really hope you like it, because we do.
We were all recruited onto this idea by the Muse and Nuwa.
Basically, the idea of this film came around the importance of like conversation, or just a conversation between two characters without too much leeway. And I think the most intimate way of doing that was probably in a car in a closed space, so the characters would feel like sort of uncomfortable or talk more.
We're all really passionate about the film. We all really love how it turned out, and it became such a labour of love for us, so we're really happy to finally see a finished product, and we hope you all like it as much as we do.
Thanks to everyone who helped us on the project. We really appreciate it.
If anybody would like to give us any feedback or let us know what you think, we'd love to hear. This is how you can get in contact with us.
Hope you enjoyed the film!
I love this.
Better, it looked good. That hurt. Bye.
Bye!
Okay. Also,
bye.
We need jobs!
No, 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 you did this! Stop it! Stop it!
Where are you going?
Hey there!
dangerous. Again. I like your beard.
What the? Stop that. Ugh, you're not real. This isn't real.
I am real.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you are not real.
But I'm Goober.
But you're not real.
Look, that's me. See? That's me, and that's Mikey, and that's me and Mikey. See? Mikey!
Would you stop that?
This is the time you went camping and built a campfire and told stories and you showed us how to put up a tent, and in the morning you let us go get firewood.
Yeah, he was determined to find the biggest log in the whole campsite. God love him, he could barely carry his sleeping bag.
Yeah. We got lost, and you can find us for hours and hours and hours.
I looked everywhere. I shouldn't have let him go. I should have found him.
So, where are we going? Can we go home now?
I'm not going back there.
Why?
Because they don't need me. He doesn't need me.
Why?
I'll just mess it up again.
Why?
He deserves a better dad.
Why?
Because I'm not good enough! Goober, I'm sorry. Goober!
Hey!
You scared me half to death. Don't do that.
I'm sorry. Just wanted to see the lights. Wow, this is pretty.
Yeah. I always loved it up here.
Have you ever taken Mikey up here? He would love it.
No, I couldn't. My dad took me up here all the time, when he was still around.
Why? Don't you like Mikey?
No, I love him. He's such a good kid. He's smart and so funny. He deserves the best dad.
You don't have to be the best dad in the world. You just have to be there. You just have to try. Don't you wish your dad had a tried?
Thank you.